Is TMG, or trimethylglycine, also known as betaine, a good source of glycine?
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
Jeff Huseby says, is supplemental TMG an adequate source of glycine, or would it ultimately just provide extra methyl groups the glycine would then have to buffer? I would regard TMG and glycine as completely separate. They're not entirely separate. There is some interchange, but I think it would get wildly confusing to try to manage your status of one with the other. Generally speaking, TMG would donate methyl groups. So glycine as a methyl buffer, it's not like there's every methyl group that comes in depletes a molecule of glycine, because if you think about the meaning of a buffer is something that sort of stabilizes you, well, at least in chemistry. And this isn't chemistry, it's biochemistry. But if you sort of borrow what a buffer means from chemistry, a buffer is going to sort of keep you in a certain range and prevent you from going to the extremes. So glycine is sort of a biochemical version of that with methylation, where glycine will take extra methyl groups when they're extra, and then we'll release them when they're not there, when you don't have enough. And if you exceed the capacity of the glycine buffer system, you will lose the methyl groups and the glycine, but that's after you exceed a certain threshold of being able to hold on to them and release, hold on and release. So it's not the default that one extra methyl group from TMG is going to make one molecule of glycine get lost. Generally, you're going to have, if you put TMG into the system, you're going to lose methyl groups, and you're going to wind up with probably the dimethylglycine going into the mitochondrion, and most likely getting those methyl groups stripped away later. And it will generate glycine. But your glycine's now going to sort of be disproportionately driven into the compartments and tissues that are using it for methylation buffering. And so, I don't know, maybe that improves your glycine status, but I'm not so sure about that, and I wouldn't rely on it. So I would just treat them completely differently. Thank you, Jeff, for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ Masterpass, where I hold monthly private Zoom Q&As for my members. The Masterpass also serves as a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. If you'd like to participate in these Q&As, you can join the Masterpass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for 10% lifetime discount. I am currently working full-time on finishing my first book, Vitamins and Minerals 101, How to Get the Nutrients You Need on Any Diet. I will let you know when I have a release date. In the meantime, you can pre-order the book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. Testing Nutritional Status, The Ultimate Cheat Sheet, has been newly released as version 1.3. This is my comprehensive system for managing nutritional status with lab tests, dietary analysis, and comprehensive intake of your signs and symptoms. The new version has a comprehensive guide to interpreting the Genova methylation panel. You can pick up your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. Please consider supporting my work at no extra cost to you by visiting my support page and making a purchase with one of my affiliate links. Some of my most popular affiliates are also listed in the description of this video with links that will give me credit for your purchase. I will try to respond to comments when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.